We as a company have such a tremendous focus on R&D. We have a global innovation center that's fully staffed with people and equipment and all the latest, greatest instrumentation so that we can gain a tremendous amount of data and data points in order to continue to look for ways to develop new technologies and continue, again, to be relevant in our industry.
This video is brought to you by Kyocera SGS Precision Tools. Value at the spindle. If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hello and welcome to Tooling Up. I'm your host, Toni Neary, and I'm so glad that you've joined us here today. But first things first, if you're new around here, go ahead and click that like and subscribe button so you don't miss any of our upcoming episodes of Tooling Up. I'm so excited today to be talking all about multi-carb tooling solutions with Jason Wells. And Jason is the Vice President of Product Innovation for Kyocera SGS Group. Jason, thanks so much for joining us today and welcome to Tooling Up.
Thanks for having me here today, Toni. It's a pleasure to be a part of the Tooling Up series and really honored to be able to share some information with the audience today.
Awesome. And one of the things I love to jump in is I want to know a little about your career path. Like, how did you end up here and what did that journey look like for you?
I came in at a really interesting time at SGS. We were a privately held family company and went through a transition of, you know, going from first generation to second generation and then fast forwarding to today to where we're part of a multinational conglomerate and had the unique experiences to work at really every level of our organization and different aspects to an extent with the company. I started out of high school and fast forwarding time 32, 33 years later, I haven't spent that entire amount of time with SGS. I have left the company to work for other organizations, always within the tooling area and tooling arena of our industry, and then returned back. So in all actuality, as strange as it may sound, this is my fourth time around with SGS and hopefully final.
And I love that. I love to hear the story that you know, you've left and you've always ended up coming back there. It's kind of like a boomerang, and I'm Australian, so I know a little thing or two about that. But seeing the company in so many phases and stages, really, what have you learned from that experience?
As we've seen machines advance, it certainly has pushed more on us as tooling manufacturers to find ways to keep up with the machines. And as those advance, it's pushed on tool holding manufacturers and fixturing and coolant folks. And so we're all interrelated once that machining process occurs. And just to see the need to continue to evolve and continue to grow as a company, not always because out of desire, but sometimes out of necessity, quite honestly.
And I love that you talk about evolution and you talk about change, but one thing that really hasn't changed is that SGS Kyocera, that customer success factor. And I know that that sounds like, you know, being a part of tooling solutions and constantly evolving, you're meeting shifting demands. Talk with me a little bit about multi-carb tools. Like, what are the advantages? How has this evolution happened? When were they first introduced?
As we started to see advancements, and we also started to see customers strive for greater productivity improvements to be more competitive, it really forced us to start to look at the tooling in ways that we could adapt them or adopt them to be more advantageous in very specific situations rather than looking at a one-size-fits-all sort of scenario. And so what we've done is in our industry is we've created a whole section of tooling known as high-performance tooling. In most situations, what we've done is we've taken that geometry and we've adjusted it, we've adapted it to gain all of the benefits we can for a very specific purpose or a very specific need, whether that be material based or operational based or what have you. The multi-carb is one of those products that fall into our high performance product range that really fell into that category. So as CAD/CAM programming, machines, being able to look ahead and to be able to take advantage of higher feed and speed rates and productivity rates. What we found is the ability to embrace what's known as high efficiency or high speed machining. And in that situation, you know, flute count becomes really important. And that is a really big aspect of that multi-carb. And why it's called multi-carb is that offering is available in 7, 9, and 11 flutes or number of cutting edges on that tool, which allows us to harness some of those advantages in high efficiency machining and in advanced machining applications.
And I think really looking at customer satisfaction, the evolution, the collaborations, talk a little bit about the types of industries that you're seeing the impact with multi-carb tools.
We're seeing the multi-carb really take advantage and be advantageous to us in industries that are machining, I'll call difficult to machine materials, or what are often termed as high temperature alloys. These would be your Inconels and your Wasp alloys and your titaniums. And these materials are tremendous for their end use. You see it a lot in defense and aerospace and medical because they have tremendous structural integrity. And they hold up extremely well because of their low thermal conductivity to high temperatures. The challenge for us as a cutting tool company is those traits that make them so wonderful for the applications that they're going to be used in make them that much more difficult for us to machine, to shape into a finished part through a machining process.
Tell us a little bit about the training that goes into deployment of some of the technology, like the multi-carb, for your customers and your end users and, you know, your MSC metal cutting specialists that are out there in the field as well.
We have a tremendous tool clinic program that's staged in different levels that you can advance into, where we bring folks in for a week and do actual hands-on training out of our research center, our Global Innovation Center. We'll do on-site training for customers where needed. We do customer projects all the time where we bring in customer projects, we'll dissect them, get all the details pulled together, and then we'll go back with a deliverable and train them on what we did, how we implemented a solution. But definitely most importantly is our network of application and sales engineers that we have out in the field. Because as you said, it's not as easy as just handing a tool and saying good luck. And also when we're introducing new technology, the whole idea of it being new is first time we're seeing it, you know, we've never really been down this road before. So we want to make sure that it's being applied appropriately so that we can make sure that, that tool is being fully taken advantage of, that all of the productivity that's available to that customer, all the productivity that's available on that tool is fully being extracted and being taken advantage of by our customers.
Jason, thank you so much for your time today. I feel like I learned a ton.
It was my pleasure.
I'm continually impressed with SGS Kyocera, and Jason, you've left no exception there whatsoever. So I loved hanging out with Jason today, and if you enjoyed our conversation and you want to make sure you don't miss any other ones, please make sure to subscribe to our channel. To find out more about these multi-carb tooling solutions, visit www.mscdirect.com/SGS. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level. And subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.